Then come aboard, British pig. Quite a little surprise, yeah? But perhaps you would be so kind as to tell us all you know about certain Allied shipping routes, yeah? Come on, talk.
Hello, Fritz. The table seems to have turned, old chap. Let's see how you like a bit of your own medicine, eh? Come on, Fritz, now tell us. Tell us about the...
Greetings, Comforter Stoke. Very sorry, but must inform you that you are now prisoner of People's Republic.
I'm very sorry, Comrade Commando, but I have just picked up a capitalist ship on Ladle Scannel.
Oh, I got a horn.
Women and children first.
Do not rush for the lifeboats. And remember, women and children first.
Red Indians. Why did you have to get dressed up like that?
It was the only thing left.
All right. Women, children, and red Indians.
And spacemen.
Here is a revised list. Women, children, red Indians, and spacemen.
What's that meant to be?
Well, it's a sort of impression of what a kind of Renaissance courtier artist might have looked like at the courts of one of the great families, like the Medicis or the Borgias.
No, it's not. It looks more Flemish than Italian.
Yes, that's a Flemish merchant of the 15th or 16th centuries.
What, with these tassels?
Yes, yes, they had those fitted doublets going tapering down into the full hose, you know, exactly like that.
One moment, please. Don't panic. Now, what's it meant to be? I've got to tell them something. Is it a Flemish merchant?
No, it is not a Flemish merchant. It's more a sort of idealised version of the complete Renaissance man.
Oh, all right. All right. This is your captain speaking. Do not rush for the lifeboats. Women, children, red Indians, spacemen, and sort of idealised versions of complete Renaissance men first.
Flemish merchants did not wear hand-embroidered chevrons. They did not.
Yes, Gomez. We found them walking on the beach, my cap. Gomez, why can't you say this? What? Oh, I see, we can't afford it. You see, the BBC has to pay an actor 20 guineas if he speaks, and it makes a bit of a hole in the budget.
28 guineas, sir.
Yes. Oh, you fool!
Solace! 28 guineas!
What about me, sir?
Are you supposed to speak?
No, sir.
Well, you've just spoken!
Oh, sorry, sir.
You fool! That's 56 guineas before we've even started! Yes! What did you do that for?
It's a stunt, sir. An extra 20 guineas.
Look, we can't afford it! The BBC has shown the money as it is!
The BBC wishes to deny rumours that it is going into liquidation. Mrs. Kelly, who owns the flat where they live, has said that they can stay on till the end of the month. And we've just heard that Hugh Weldon's watch has been accepted by the London Electricity Board and transmissions for this evening can be continued as planned. Well, that's all from me, so good night to you.
Are you going to be in there all night?
It's just a bulletin, Mr. Kelly. And now, back to the story.
Come in!
All right.
We found these men walking on the beach, my capitan.
We are British naval officers and entitled to be...
It's Puss!
Hello, children!
Stop! Stop this adaptation of Puss in Boots! This is the police department of the state of Venezuela!
Oh, no, it isn't!
Oh, yes, it is!
Oh, no, it isn't!
Some questions. And remember, if you do not give me correct answers,
We have ways of making you answer.
Like not paying 28 guineas.
Shut up! Now, what ship are you from?
We are from the SS Mother Goose. We were 12 days out from Port of Spain and...
I got 30 bob for the trousers.
We are from the SS Mother Goose. We were 12 days out from Port of Spain. And one night, I was doing my usual rounds when I had occasion to pass the forward storage lockers.
Go on!
I noticed something unusual. The main bilge hatches had been opened, and there, crouching amidst the scuppers, was the most ghastly creature I'd ever seen in my life. As soon as it saw me, its horrible face split aside in a ghastly look of terror. Its head, which was like a small rat,
thank you,
was ghastly and horrible than before. Its little red eyes glinted in the unaccustomed glare of the midday sun. And before I could shut the hatch, it sprang upon me with one almighty bound.
What's this about doing Horse of the Year show in here tonight?
Oh, I'm sorry, Silas, you don't know, I'm afraid this is drama.
Mr. Fox told me before he went down to the pub that they're doing Horse of the Year show in here tonight at 9:10.
Well, this is BBC Two.
I think BBC One are in the kitchen.
Well, I'm not having Harvey Smith jumping over my binet.
No, come on! Tearing at my throat, ripping my clothes.
And turn the gas off before you leave.
All right! I thought it with all my strength, but it was too much for me. It's supernatural power.
Round for Harvey Smith on O'Malley. And now it's Mrs. David Barker riding Atalanta, number 3.
It's one of our most popular programmes.
That's what you think, Mr. Fox.
Well, that's all from BBC Television.
Come on!